Grace Baptist Church, man, we are excited about tomorrow. We're doing our soft opening of our church, and I want to wish all the mothers, first and foremost, a happy Mother's Day. And I know that that comes a little bit early, but we're excited about all the moms tomorrow celebrating this. But this will be our soft opening of the church this Sunday, May 10th, which is tomorrow. And the service is going to start at 11 o'clock. And this opening is going to come with quite a few restrictions that we have planned to abide by, and we're going to enforce. Now, we're going to ask that you read, of course, the guidelines that we've sent out to you by email. And I'm going to cover those guidelines with you right now. But we're going to ask you to read those guidelines again to make sure that you're understanding what the expectation is going to be like for tomorrow. And as things get going, we're going to get back into a routine of church and so forth. It's exciting for me. I hope it's exciting for you. Now, we are going to be having an 11 a.m. service. So please understand 11 a.m. service. And if we asked you if you'd prefer to either come to a.m., if you prefer to come to a p.m. or a Wednesday night, I'm going to say that we have seating for everybody opened up in here with plenty of distancing, and we're very excited about that. We've worked very, very hard, in fact, all day long. The crew has been up here working for that, and so we can say that we can open up church for everybody to come at the 11 o'clock service, as well as the 6 o'clock evening service, as well as Wednesday service at 7 o'clock. And so we're going to be having the 11 a.m. service and the 6 p.m. service. Now, there will not be any Sunday school on the property at this time. So your Sunday school is going to continue to be going on through Zoom or through Google Meet or whatever platform your Sunday school teacher chooses to use. I am going to say that the bookstore will remain locked at this time. We're not going to be using the bookstore. However, I believe that we're going to have a table set up. If you'd like to go by and pick up your devotionals, which you haven't been able to get, we will have that ready for you. Brother Hutton will be doing that. And that way you can get your Baptist bread or your Glow devotionals, which will be available for purchase. We also ask that all members that you're going to park in the north and northwest parking lot to come through either of the two north doors. There's a northeast door. If you're facing me, that would be on your left-hand side, but the northeast door is closest to Nevada. The northwest doors are going to be closest to the mountains, all right? And we're going to ask you to either come through either one of those doors. And so that's very important. These will be remaining unlocked, and so we want you to be able to do that. And then we're also going to ask all the members to park your cars right on the north parking lot, if at all possible. Now, the west door is located closest to the bookstore, will be open for families needing to utilize the handicap ramp as well as the nurseries for the services. Now, what we're talking about is the single door off the handicap ramp nearest the bookstore. That's the only door that's going to be opened over there. The two big double wide doors will not be open. So make sure you make note of that. Just a single door. And we only ask that one parent take the children to the nursery. All right. If you're choosing to use the nurseries, we're asking that one parent, and not a teenager, that one parent to get the children to the nurseries. And we'll say a little bit more about that here in a moment. The Spanish ministry is going to be using the lower level, and they're going to be using the ramp that heads down to the lower level and entering in that way. Now, let me talk to you a little bit about restrooms really quick, Grace Baptist. Restrooms are going to be open for use, all right? And especially these bathrooms over here near and closest to the bookstore. They're going to be open for use. And what we're going to ask is, first of all, use the restroom before you come to church. Just do everything you can in your power to use the restroom. Now, if you have to use the restroom, we understand. We're not going to beat you up for having to use the restroom. But we're going to ask you to at least try to use the restroom before you come so we don't have to use these restrooms here. But if you have to use the restroom, we're going to ask that or there's no more than two people in the restroom at a time. And of course, form a line outside the restroom if you have to, keeping a 6-foot distance between the people that are in front of you to the restroom and only two in the restroom at a time so we can practice the social distancing. Now, let's see here. The cafeteria is going to be closed, so make sure that you are understanding that there won't be any use of the cafeteria. Clorox wipes are going to be available inside the restrooms. In other words, when you get finished using the restroom, clean up after yourself. If you touch the handle, use a Clorox wipe to clean that up and to make sure that you clean up after yourself so it's ready to be used for the next person that comes in. And let's do everything we can in our power. Make that mental note to use the restroom before you even come to church. Now I'm going to talk about sanctuary and seating. Sanctuary and seating. Now, we've worked very hard. You're going to see that some of the rows are in disarray. We have seats pulled up. We have them in a half moon shape. We have 6 feet between each row. Some rows are completely taped off. If you come down into some of these rows, you'll find caution tape. Don't remove that caution tape. That caution tape is not to be touched. It's there for a reason. For example, I have sitting in these three rows right here, the Cruz family. All right, I got the Cruises sitting here. Then there's three seats right here that said caution. Nobody sits inside there. And then I have two seats opened up right here that are going to be used by the Hutton family, Doris, and her husband right there. And that way I have the social distancing in between. Now, that's going to be throughout the entire auditorium. And we've done everything we can in our power to make sure that we reserved you a seat practicing the social distancing. And so when you please come in, our ushers are going to be helping you see. Your names are on the back. Please do not mess with the signs on the back of these seats. Don't mess with the signs. It's very important that we leave these here because this is going to be your assigned seat for a while until things get back to normal when we get back to living our lives in a normal way, in a normal fashion. Let's see here. Ushers will be using the empty rows of chairs to walk through to pass the offering plates. And so if I have an empty row of chairs, that's where the ushers are going to walk through, and they're going to carry it in front of you. So that way you don't have to touch an offering plate. It's going to come right in front of you. You can stand up and put your offering in. And so bring your tithe with you. You're excited about that. Amen. Bring that tithe with you. Let's make sure that we're doing our part in tithes and offerings. And the ushers will be here to do that. Now, family units should stay together. When you're on the premises, all right, for example, I have the Gibson sitting over here. The entire Gibson family needs to be sitting together. They don't need to be co-mingling with friends and so forth at that time. Teenagers don't need to be co-mingling together. I don't want to see teenagers grouping up in hallways. I want to see when you come to church, you need to get into the auditorium, get to your place, and stay in that place until we dismiss you to go home. And that's what the important thing is, all right? And we're going to practice the social distancing as much as possible. Ushers are going to use the empty rows, like I said. Family units should stay together, like I said. Very important that we do that. And the only reason why you ought to be on the school wing side of things, and I'm talking about beyond the double grade doors by the bookstore and over here on the west side, the only persons that need to belong over there are children 3 years old and younger with one parent to take them to the nursery. All right, and very important. Now, if you're bringing your children, you're not placing them in the nursery, understand that you're welcome to do that. And we're going to ask you to come with your children that probably are nursery age. If you choose not to put them in, that's your prerogative. But we are going to ask that if they do get fussy, that we're going to have some areas that you can go to with a fussy child. You might have to take them out of the service while they're fussy, but go to a particular location over here on the west side over here or by the bookstore over here are probably the best locations. Or there's a little table over here that's over here on the east side that you can go to and take your child out over there if they're going to be fussy. Now, if you've been sick, if you have been running a fever, if you have the sniffles, a cough, a cold, whatever you might have, all right, we're going to ask you to stay away. Don't come tomorrow. We want to make sure that we're not going to be passing on those germs. So please make sure that you're doing everything you can to protect others, not only yourself, but others. And no handshaking when you get on premises. No hugging. Oh, I know we haven't seen each other for a while. And the thing is that I'm really close friends with them. I'm okay with that. No, let's not start an environment of that. Look, you guys might be close friends and you might be comfortable in doing that when you're off the premises. But when you're on the premises, please help us by abiding by these rules. Now, with the nurseries, let me say a little bit more about that. We realize that small children most likely will not sit through an entire service, so we will have nursery rooms open for your use under the following guidelines. Both the nurseries, the 2 and 3-year-old rooms, will be open. The limit will be 10 people. After 10, we'll use other rooms as overflow. No snacks, drinks, or will be allowed. Since we'll only have one service, these really should not be needed. Mothers can make and heat up bottles when necessary. All children should be changed only in the nursery at the designated areas. There will be a disposable changing pads, gloves, wipes, Clorox wipes, hand sanitizers available for your use. Please analyze or sanitize after using before you leave. Nurseries will be up to 3 years old. 4-year-olds should be able to sit with their parents in the sanctuary and so forth. So that we're abiding by the CDC guidelines and any rules that the local stores would enforce, leadership and ushers have been instructed to watch for and enforce these temporary policies. So please do your best to watch that your family is doing the same. Please follow all the posted signs. We have posted signs everywhere. Take time to read the posted signs, all right? We have them on these pillars over here. We have them by the double doors over there. We have them on each double door. We have them on walls. Take a moment to look at them. We're going to be throwing them up on the screen. Take a moment to look at the posted signs. These are all reminders. Look, you say, well, I'm not as scared of this thing as some people are, all right? But some people are, all right? You may be comfortable with where you're at, but some people aren't. And we have to work together with everybody in our church, all right? We want people to come to church and feel comfortable that we're doing everything we can within our power to make sure that they're in an environment where they feel like we've done everything to protect them, yet while they're still having church, all right? And so that's very important to me. If you're elderly and you feel like you're at risk, all right, please use wisdom in attending the services. Live streams will still be available. And so, look, if you're vulnerable to this, all right, and I'm asking you to just use your wisdom on that. You're adults, and you need to make sure that you're using your own wisdom. If you feel that masks and gloves are necessary, they're the best for precautionary measures for you. We encourage you to wear your masks and gloves, all right? Unfortunately, we will not have masks or gloves available. So if you're going to wear masks and gloves, make sure that you bring your own masks and gloves with you. Make sure if you seem that they're necessary, please bring them with you. Wear them, all right? Nobody's going to think you're weird, all right? I don't think people are weird in Walmart for wearing them or down at Lowe's for wearing them. If you feel like that's necessary, please come to church and make yourself feel as safe and comfortable as you possibly can, all right? As much as we're excited to return to church, and we are, we want to be wise. We want to take all the precautions when needed. And so, look, we've done our best to cover everybody in our church who signed up and even those who have not yet signed up. But I believe that we've done really good at getting everybody spread out. And our ushers are going to be here tomorrow early. I had asked that if you are coming to the 11 o'clock service, if you're, of an adult age, and you don't have small children, I'd really ask that you get here a little bit earlier so we can get you seated in your places so we can get the parents with their children in their places. I'm excited about church, all right? And I know that there's a lot going on. I know I offered a lot in here, and there's a lot more in this email, all right? Man, I'm excited. We have up here on the stage, we have 8 people that are going to be standing up here singing an ensemble. Very, very excited to hear the ensemble. We're going to have church as much as possible, normal. So at 11 o'clock tomorrow, 6 o'clock tomorrow night, Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, and we have enough seating for everybody to come to all services, So please come. We even have some open seats that are available for visitors or overflow. Maybe we missed you, didn't do that intentionally. By the way, if somebody got missed, don't let your feelings get hurt. We love you. We thank God for you. We've covered this thing over and over and over again. And throughout covering, there are some people who didn't sign up, but we put a name out there anyway. All right. We want to make sure that you have an ability to be able to come to church tomorrow. So please come. And if you have any questions, feel free to call. Let's see here. You can call my wife and talk with her on her cell phone. Please don't call mine. I'm going to be talking to Jesus all night tonight on my knees in prayer for a good day in church. Amen. We love you, church. Looking forward to a great service tomorrow. And we trust that You come prepared. If you have your own sanitary things, please bring them with you. We're going to actually have some of that here at the church as well. We're going to have some sanitizer here at the church. So please, let's all of us do our part to do our best to watch over each other and be precautionary. And ushers, tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock, let's be here. I think security tomorrow, 10:30. And let's all be in our places, ready to go, and looking forward to a great day tomorrow. We love you, Grace Baptist Church. And I'm going to close with a word of prayer. Father, I pray that, Lord, that you will help us tomorrow as we open up the church as a soft opening. I pray that, Lord, that you'll watch over each and every one of us. Give us your safety and your protection. Help us to have a great service. May your power be evident there. And Lord, watch over each and every member. We sure do love you, Lord, and thank you for all your goodness to us. Be with the services tomorrow now. In Jesus' name, amen.